Hello, dear Cinders. Etalyx here, wanting to make a brief video on a game called Mirage, Arcane Warfare, which is currently in beta and due for release some point this year in 2017. Mirage Arcane Warfare should sound familiar to you because it's by the developers Torn Banner Studios, who are pretty famous now for Chivalry Medieval Warfare, as opposed to Arcane. Chivalry was a big hit with me and my group of friends back in, I think, 2012, around the time when it released. I had a blast pouring tens of hours into the game, never a professional or anything like that. I'm a fairly casual player, and I'm coming at this video from that perspective, so keep that in mind, giving my opinions as a casual to other presumable casuals. No offense. Mirage is at its core much like Chivalry in that both are online melee combat games, but the primary difference being here that Mirage allows magic to be channeled through ranged casters who can strike from afar with projectiles of the elemental nature. But the magic usage is not limited to just one class. All classes, six of them from what I've seen in the beta so far, each have their own special, magical oftentimes, abilities that enhance your normal armaments of swinging horizontally, swinging vertically, and stabbing, the three primary ways to deal damage in Arcane, unless you are one of the casters themselves who prefer to stay back, much like the archers in Chivalry Medieval Warfare, and stay out of harm's direct path. Every character has a Q, E, and R ability by default. That's three. However, there are six in total right now for every class to choose from. You will pick three of those. You can't pick just any three. It's limited. So Q has two abilities, E has two abilities, and R has two abilities. And you will select the one that you think augments your class the most for that particular encounter. Speaking of encounters, what I've currently been able to play in Mirage include Team Deathmatch, which is what you're primarily seeing here. There's also a Capture the Flag game mode I've tried, and I believe a Control Point. None of these were compelling to me, unfortunately. And that's my biggest criticism against Mirage right now, is that my fondest memories of Chivalry Medieval Warfare are the spectacle of it all. Jumping into the objective game types, charging with all of your team together for Agatha, or whatever side you happen to be on at that time. Go Agatha. Here, however, we only have the side game modes, the ones that I avoided at all costs in Chivalry. And again, that's just my own personal preference, but they were certainly, I would say, the least popular game modes in Chivalry, at least when I was playing. So here, I'm anticipating the advent of objective game types. There's not any just yet that I've been able to try out, so I think that they're not in the game at this point. I've looked at the frequently asked questions from Mirage, and it has confirmed that objective game modes are indeed coming down the pipes. So hopefully I won't have to wait too long to experience the biggest draw for me personally into Mirage, because as it stands right now, it doesn't have a lot of staying power in my current gaming palette. The gameplay itself hasn't changed much since 2012, and I think that's probably why. In my first few hours playing Mirage, I felt like I was playing Chivalry with another coat of paint. The controls from the movement, the running, the swinging, all feel so reminiscent of that game from years ago, and sometimes a new coat of paint is good. Taking something tried and true that works, making it sparkle and shine. The issue for me is that the moment-to-moment mechanics and gameplay, that was never the draw. It was, as I said, how grandiose the missions felt, going in with your team to kill the enemy king, or standing around as the king's guard protecting him, who himself was an actual player, which was very unique. The game mode was working in tandem with the mechanics, limited though they kind of are, to make a bigger picture. And here, when you've stripped away half of that picture, I'm left with only the mechanics themselves. And I was never too impressed with them, having been a player that came first from Mountain Blade and Warband into Chivalry. And I always thought that the fighting was a little bit stripped down by comparison. Having one block button that blocks in all directions, the focal point being more on navigating around and flanking your enemy to hit them from the side where they're not blocking, or feinting, which is the act of canceling your attack as soon as the swing begins, playing mind games with your opponent, tricking them into triggering their limited time block, opening up a vulnerability at the end of their block for your real swing to connect and drive home its point into your target. So Chivalry does have some strategy there. But unfortunately, by itself, basic melee combat isn't enough anymore. It feels dated at this point, and I assume that it has some influence on the decision to give every class three special abilities to try to mix up the gameplay a bit more, breathe some life into things. And with that advent of abilities, it draws comparisons to other games with abilities. I'm thinking Paladins, I'm thinking Overwatch. I know what you're thinking. Etalyx, Chivalry, and Mirage are nothing like Overwatch and Paladins. Okay, Overwatch is better. Paladins is free to play, that's why I play it. Just calm down for a second. All I'm saying is that Chivalry before, yes, might have had throwing axes and little throwables of that nature, but they're not the same as having three swappable abilities for every class. Here, with Magic, it draws comparisons for me to games like Overwatch and Paladins, which have abilities as well, oftentimes 3 plus an ultimate, in this case just 3. If you take out the ultimate, that doesn't mean there's no similarities here, do you see what I'm saying? And comparatively, Mirage's abilities all feel way clunkier to use. And it's difficult to explain exactly what I mean by clunky. But basically, certain abilities have far too long of a wind-up time, for example, between depressing the key and waiting to see the on-screen result. And when you do strike hits, the kinetic combat that felt new and fresh in 2012 doesn't quite hold up after 4 to 5 years later. Especially with the release of another melee combat game called For Honor, which I've played a bunch of recently. And it may not seem fair for me to make that comparison. Maybe it's not, but both games will have released in 2017, the difference being one of the two is twice as expensive as the other, with Mirage being $30 right now to pre-order, which will get you access to the beta at the time of this recording. So if you really, really love Chivalry and you want to try it out, it's now available for anybody to buy into. But I hesitate to advise you to do that because I'm still waiting on the objective game types. And I think when those come out, I will change my tune considerably because being in the throng, the thick of combat, the heat of the moment, trying to protect, having a goal in mind outside of team deathmatch or capture the flag or the capture modes where you're trying to defend certain control points, I think those are so boring without the overarching objective, with the big quote-unquote story maps. So I'd like to revisit this game when that releases. What made Chivalry so great for me was the marriage between experience and gameplay. And here, there's just gameplay for now, until the experience can be added at a later date. So I know it seems unfair to judge it, but the absence of that experience has put the focus, the spotlight, on the gameplay, and it's revealed to me that the gameplay feels antiquated. It does feel 4 or 5 years old, and I don't think that it stands up to the test of time. And unfortunately, adding in special abilities on top of the old swing and block gameplay isn't enough to bring it back up to what at the time was a very unique proposition. Sure, Mountain Blade had been out and I'd played it, and Chivalry still managed to carve out a place in my heart. It was elevated to a position where I could enjoy both Mountain Blade and Chivalry for different reasons. It was still unique, even though it borrowed a couple of gameplay mechanics. Iterative is a good word. Mirage, on the other hand, feels like it's sitting on the shoulders of the giant that is Chivalry, hoping to see above the clouds into the great beyond. But I don't know if it gets there just by adding magic and special abilities while maintaining the same melee combat at its base. All of this is not to say that Mirage is a bad game. I think it's okay, but unfortunately okay isn't good enough for me to make a $30 purchase recommendation for. It's a game I want to check back out in a few months, maybe when it releases, hopefully with some more addictive game modes, because right now I have no desire to hop back into a capture the flag or a team deathmatch. But either way, I thank you for watching this video. Hope you found it informative, and if not, yell at me in the comments below. See if I care. My name is Etalyx, I'll see you next time.